Man, good morning. Lekker koffiekies vir oggend again. Whew. Hope yours is ready. Hope you got your socks on, because... Well, actually, I mean they're off, because... Yo, this has been hitting me and blowing my mind pretty much since last night. You know, one of those really sort of just thoughts, and hopefully it hits you a little bit too. And there's two things that are on my mind. And I'm asking, and I'm here this morning asking God, Lord, what's up? And then I realized they kind of go togetherness. These two thoughts that I had. We had our weekly church small group gathering last night. We get together and discuss a little bit in a smaller group on a more personal level. And touch about the message that the pastor preached on Sunday. And, you know, one of the sections, or one of the questions we had to answer, is where in our past did we feel left out, pushed aside, cast out, excluded, and how did this make us feel? And there were some incredible stories that came out, some incredible stories of growth that came out through there, and we ended up in such a way that everybody that was there shared a testimony of somewhere, a thought of somewhere. And so I know, for instance, from my side, I shared from a place I've shared before, but in the moment, as everybody was sharing, God was revealing something else to me about certain things of back then that I got to share. And it was really, and that in itself then added, and it was just truly phenomenal. And afterwards, I sat there and I just had this urge, and I had this feeling, and I just had to ask if there's anybody else in the room right now that's feeling a little bit less alone, a little bit less lonely, realizing that we were a room of, I think it was 11 of us, and all 11 of us had a story. And you can see, well, I could see, it looked to me like all 11 of us, everybody had more than one story. So at some point in everybody's life, you're an outcast. You feel like an outcast. Let me rather say it that way. And there are many more people around us than you may think, than you may realize. Doesn't matter who and what they are today. I, for example, I'm where I am today because where of God, where God has brought me from, where God has healed me from, where God has restored me from. Also a place of oppression, which I've shared many a times, but I was reminded this morning that the enemy will come and lie to you. He will tell you that you're not worthy of those people's attention. He'll tell you that you don't belong there, that you're an outcast, that you're not good enough for them. You're not good enough to be there. You're not good enough to do this. And I need to tell you right now that that's nonsense. That is lies of the enemy. Klar. There's nothing else to it, because God said that you have been set apart. And the same scripture that came to my mind last night, Jeremiah chapter 1 and verse 5, where it says, before I formed you in the womb, I knew you. Before you were born, I sanctified you. I ordained you a prophet to the nations. I sanctified you. This word sanctify hit me this morning. And it is to... Some of the words they used to describe this word, or to define it, is to be set apart as, or declared holy, consecrated, made legitimate, purified. To be set apart, to be made holy by God before you were born. You were set apart for Him. So badly, I felt this in my life so badly that it doesn't matter which room I'm in. It doesn't matter if I try my hardest to blend in. I have a broken blender, standing out like a sore thumb on other kind of levels. And there's a couple of scriptures that came with this this morning's Romans 1:1, where it says, Paul, a bondservant of Jesus Christ, called to be an apostle, separated to the gospel of God. And I had to just go check out bondservant as well, because that is a very specific word that I learned only a few months ago in this manner, where a bondservant is somebody almost who chooses in the end of the day. But it says, what I found is it's a translation of the Greek word doulos, or dolos, if I'm saying it right, which means one who is subservient to and entirely at the disposal of his master, a slave, entirely at the disposal of his master, one who will do everything. In my own words, I feel this is somebody that's completely sold out to God and for God to do with as he pleases. And that they obey no matter what. Doesn't matter how I feel about it. Doesn't matter if I'm fearful or not about it. If God says, I go. That's my words on how I understand it. In 1 Peter chapter 2, oh man. In verse 9 where he says, he comes again and he counts harder and he says, but you are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, his own special people, that you may proclaim the praises of him who called you out of the darkness and into his marvelous light. He's called you into his marvelous light, my friend. Out of the darkness of the lies of the enemy. Out of the darkness of bondage. Out of the darkness of chains where the enemy's got to tie down and chain down. And it doesn't matter where you were. You feel so left out, but you feel like you stand out like a sore thumb. This is how I felt a lot. It's like I'm busy watching the sheep in the field. I'm not even in the room, but they were sent for me. Like you know, that's how far God has chosen you. Doesn't matter where you are. Like Saul, I don't know if Saul knew that he was chosen. I think he may have. I can't remember the exact scriptures now before leading to this point in Samuel, but Saul was hiding, and they were sent for him because he was chosen. You are chosen, my friend. God will send for you, and if he has sent for you, he will keep sending for you because you were chosen. In 1 Samuel chapter 10, I have to read this. And when Samuel had caused, so Samuel came to anoint a new king. And it said, and when Samuel had caused all the tribes of Israel to come near, the tribe of Benjamin was chosen. Chosen. When he had caused the tribe of Benjamin to come near by their families, the family of Matri was chosen. And Saul, the son of Kish, was chosen. But when they sought him, look at this, he could not be found. And they looked for him. He wasn't there. He says, therefore they inquired of the Lord further. They asked the Lord, has this man come here yet? And the Lord answered, there he is, hidden among the equipment. God answered them and said, there he is. Don't look for, he's here. Yes, he's here. There he is. So they ran and brought him from there. And when he stood among the people, look at this, standing out. When he stood among the people, he was taller than any of the people from his shoulder upwards. I wonder if this is where the saying comes from, you stand out head and shoulders above the rest. I wonder if this is where that comes from. That's how tall and how big and massive of a man he was. And Samuel said to all the people, do you see him whom the Lord has chosen? That there is no one like him among all the people. Are you listening to this? Do you see him who the Lord has chosen, that there is no one like him among all the people? So all the people shouted and said, long live the king. Long live the king. He might not have been chosen to be a king, but we have God as our king. But you were chosen. Nobody else is there like you to do the job that God has for you, to fulfill the role that God has for you, to do the thing that you want to do for the Lord even. And I just want to tell you this morning that you are good enough. You've been made holy. You've been made righteous through the sacrifice of Jesus. I'm reminded this morning about a song, which I still need to share with my one friend, actually, now that I think about it. But this song is from one of my OG favorite gospel artists from back in the day, a guy called Louis Brits. He's still around today. He's doing great things for gospel music still. I think they actually come into South Africa soon, but not near where I am, unfortunately, despite his love for the Eastern Cape. And it's a song called Gaan Na Jou Buurt. That roughly translates to go to your neighborhood. And in this song, he sings about people who were called for specific purposes and the excuses that they had. Like Moses was called to go to Egypt, yet he had the stutter that he's like, oh Lord, please don't send me. Jonah was so afraid that he ran away. Jonah was afraid of the people. and he ran away. You know, God called them for a very specific purpose and for a very specific reason. And that right there is because he wanted to use them. God called you because he wants to use you. Because he needs to use you because he designed you for this. He doesn't ask you if you're able to, like he did with Moses or Jonah. He didn't ask if you're able to. He doesn't ask if you can. Because he can, and he is able to, and he makes you able to do the things. Are you getting this? All he is asking is, whom shall I send? Who will go for me? That's all God is asking. And the reason why he still asks is because he wants you to choose to do it for him. He doesn't want you to be forced. And I want to tell you this morning that those stories of your past, specifically the ones that you've been healed from. Some stories might still be in the writing process, even ones from long ago. Might be still in the writing part of the process. But those are the stories, those are the testimonies that make you the perfect candidate for God's goodness and glory and grace. Of his saving power. Of the you being set apart. And how God makes and, oh man, of how God brings up his people. In my case, those things where where God fetched me from, it makes me rely on him more. Because I know he fetched me. Makes me run for him harder because I know I couldn't get out of it. And he brought me out of it. So now I'm in that space where I just, or even in times that look tough in front of me, it's the things that make me scrape together the courage to go, okay, Lord, you said it, and you could have commanded it, but you're such a gentleman that you ask. I'm afraid, Lord, and I don't know why, and I know I shouldn't be, but here I go. Because it's for your glory and not for my sake. I want to encourage you to go today, my friend. Tell someone of something that God did for you. Especially maybe in this sort of place where you felt like you were an outcast and God fixed it for you. God showed you the truth. Because God will show you the truth. Because as long as you feel like an outcast, the devil is winning. Because you're still believing his lies. And God is saying, you set apart. You don't belong with those people because you set apart. You don't feel like you fit in because you set apart. You're a chosen person. There's something in store for you. And I built you specifically for that. You just have to choose to go. If you see somebody in the room somewhere that feels like, that looks like they feel like they don't belong, go have a chat to them. Share a story with them of how you once felt set aside, pushed aside, exiled. Outcast, and how especially if you have a story of how Jesus was the ultimate savior of this, the healer of this. This is what God uses to let people know it's okay to feel that way. But here's not just a remedy, but a permanent solution. And then we got to stop believing his truth over your life. I want to encourage you today. To be his hands and feet. Be his hands and feet today. You are not alone.